Hi everyone, Giuliano here. In this video, I'm going to show you the new webinar experience in Microsoft Teams. Microsoft has worked on it to improve the experience in creating webinars in Microsoft Teams. Let me walk you through every step how you can create a webinar with the new user experience. Let's get started. Here I am in Microsoft Teams. Let's see how to create a webinar. First of all, I have to jump on my calendar. And then, in the drop-down next to New Meeting, I'm going to target Webinar. This opens another window, and here I'm ready to set up and customize my webinar. Assuming that your admin grants you the ability to create webinars in your organization, I'm going forward now. If you don't know, you can check a video that I made in the past. You can check the link in the description or in the upper right corner. Now, let's start to set up my webinar. I defined a title, how to get the most out of your intranet. Then let's select the date. I'm going to plan this webinar on next Friday. The date, it would be 11, the same date, 2/12. So I'm going to plan 1 hour of webinar. Next to the date, you have the ability to set the time zone. Very important for the user. I have this, Rome, Berlin, it's fine. And here I can add a description. I added a description. In this webinar, you'll learn how to take to the next level your internet using SharePoint Online and Microsoft Viva. Down below, I have to list the presenters. In my case, I'll be a speaker. And then, with me, there will be Adele Events, which will share the stage with me. Down below, very important, there is a rule that can help to deliver the webinar, which is the co-organizer. It is basically a moderator. During your speech, you don't need to take care to moderate the webinar by changing the meeting options or by engaging with the audience and see who raised the hand. This is another important rule. I'm going to assign the co-organizer to Diego Siciliani. Now that I have a co-organizer, I can move to the next one, which is event access. This is another important aspect. If you are going to plan to deliver your webinar internally in your organization, then you have to select private. If you are planning to deliver your webinar to everybody, then this should be public. In my case, would be public. Now that I added the first information, in order to move on, I have to save a first version of my webinar. Otherwise, I cannot move to the next steps. So let's do this. Now I have further options enabled. On the right, I have the ability to view a draft on my page of my webinar, and I can publish the webinar. If I click on the three dots, I can even cancel this event. Now let's move on top of this page. Before to move to the next step, you have the ability to add apps in your webinar. Now let's imagine that you are planning to have a poll during your webinar just to collect feedback from the audience. It makes perfectly sense in this case, click on Manage App, and now that I am in the meeting of my webinar, I can start to set up my webinar by clicking on the plus button, and then I can add the polls app, for example, because I'm planning to collect feedback from the audience. I have to add a name for this poll. I'm going to name it just feedback. Then let's click on save. Now that I added my poll app, I can click again on manage event to go back. Of course, you can add additional app if you want. Going in meeting options, I'm able to configure the webinar. This opens a new tab in the browser, and here I can deal with all options available for this webinar. I can, for example, define who can bypass the lobby. We have the classic meeting configuration, always let callers bypass the lobby, announce when callers join or leave, who can present specific people, choose presenter, in this case is Adele Events, because I set up before that Adele is going to be the co-speaker of this session. Allow camera for attendees, allow mic for attendees, record automatically, allow meeting in chat, in meeting only. Let's say that it's fine. I want to turn on just question and answer because this is a nice and great way to answer to the audience and engage with the audience. If you are going to deliver the session in different languages, it makes also sense to enable language interpretation and turn on the transcription. You have the ability to have also watermark if you are going to encrypt the webinar and the session using sensitivity label. You can enable green room, allow attendance report, and so on. So let's save now. It looks perfect now, the configuration. Let me jump back on the configuration of my webinar. Now that I am back on my configuration page, I can move to the next step, which is presenter bios. This is very cool. I am able right now to edit the speaker page, so I can add information related to the speaker. So I can add the company, for example. Now that I added all information, organization, role, LinkedIn profile, Twitter profile, the website, and a short bio description, I can add my profile picture. Let me click on the profile picture and then edit image. I'm going to upload a picture that I have here. And here you have the ability to modify and adapt the picture. Let's click on done. Let's click on save. And now the speaker presentation page is ready. I have to do the same for the events. Let me click on edit. I just added all information related to Adele events. I can save this speaker page as well. Now that I am done with this other step, I can move on theming. Here you have to apply another image, a logo, and a theme color. Let's do this. Let's click on change image and here choose another image. I'm going to apply this one that I have. Look at this, how beautiful it is. And let me keep it. So that's perfect. Let's go on save now. I have my image header apply. Let's go on logo. I'm going to do the same. This is my logo. Save. And here we go. This is now available. And now let's select a color for the theme color. I'm going to apply this one. And let's click on save. Here we go. Everything is set up for theming as well. Now I can move on registration. Let's click on configuration. Here I have the ability to adjust the capacity of my webinar. You can have up to 1,000 attendees in your webinar, but you can even decrease, of course, this number. Down below I have required manual approval or all event registration, enable waitlist for this event, limit registration date. And then here below I have the form. Out of the box, what you have in the form are required and mandatory fields, which are first name, surname, email, and Microsoft consent fields are required. If you want to add extra field, for example, the job title, which could be required as well, and the industry required as well, you can do it. Moreover, you can add custom fields going on customized questions, and then you can add a checkbox or a choices. Let's add a checkbox, for example, and here I'm going to add my field, which is, have you worked before with SharePoint Online? I'm going to add another custom field, in this case would be a choice field. And now I can say if this field is a multiple selection or if it's required, this is not required. Okay, I added this other field. Are you interested to participate to a workshop after the webinar? Yes, no, don't know. It's fine. So I added all fields that I need for my form. Let's move on. But before to do it, I have to save all changes applied. And then let's move now on attendees status. Here you have the ability, after that you publish the site, to have a look how many registration you are receiving for your webinar. Now that I completed every step, I can also publish my site. But I want to be sure that this looks very good. To do that, I'm going to click on View Draft. All right, now I open this webinar form on my browser and I see the image that I uploaded, the theme, the logo, the title of my webinar. It is a free webinar and the attendees can register to the webinar by clicking on the button Register. Then there is the date, it is an online event. We can see the details and then the speaker bios just below. I can click on Show More to see more information if the description contains more character, and there is even the button to share this form with other people. Now let's go back on Microsoft Teams. Now looks very gorgeous this webinar. I can click on the button Publish Site. Let's confirm by clicking on the button Publish. All set and ready to share. So this is the link that you can copy and share if you want to spread the event. Let me copy this link. I open an incognito session on my browser. I'm going to paste the URL of my webinar, and from an attendee perspective, I can start to register to this event. I'm going to click on Register. Here I have to provide all my information. I filled out this form providing all necessary information. I'm going to check I have read and agree, and let's click on Register. Now I am registered to the event. Let's go back to the organizer perspective to see the status of the registrations. I am back now on this event as organizer, and if I expand text, I can see the first person that has filled out the form and registered to the event, Nestor Wilkie. The email, I can click on the button More to see additional information about this person. I'm using now my smartphone and I open the registration page directly from here. As you can see, it's mobile friendly. I can see even the number of attendees right now that have registered to the event. I can see one because before Nestor Wilkie has registered to the event. I can tap on the button Register, and here I can provide the information needed to register myself to the event. Last thing that I would like to call out here is the report. Here you can have a look to all detailed activity related to your webinar. For example, you can see how many attendees have registered to the event, how many attendees was in presence during your webinar, the total event time, average attendees. And here, one by one, you can see every attendee with the status, the duration, the join time, and the leave time. Okay, we have seen how to create webinars in Microsoft Teams with the new improved user experience. If you enjoyed this video, please consider to subscribe and like. Let me know what do you think about this feature in the comment down below, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!